When I started law school, as I said earlier, there were only 5 law students in Canada. There were 3 lawyers in Canada when I started, native lawyers. As a result of that, I was the first Alberta Indian to graduate from law school, which again translated into, because of that, being the first Indian, Treaty Indian, elected to the Parliament of Canada. I hate to think about where I would be today without sports, and I really mean that seriously, because growing up on the reserve with all the usual negative statistics you hear about, I think one of the tickets out, not in a negative sense, but to get to advance yourself was through sports, for me anyway, and that's what really, really helped. And it's true. I mean, there's been a lot of instances where there's been negative experiences or just outright bad treatment of my peoples or racial discrimination against my peoples. And for me, the medium that I use to overcome that, I can't get away from it because it always comes back to me, and that is with sport. Because as you know, in sports, for example, you cannot be phony in the heat of competition. That's why I organized the Indigenous Games to a point now where if you can see a stadium where there's 8,200 Indian athletes competing with 2,000 some cultural participants and thousands of spectators, it shows you that there is an area of our life in society that transcends all of those negatives, and it has been sport. In 1977, I was asked to chair a meeting in Sweden on an international law called the Convention 169, which is an international law about indigenous peoples, all aspects of indigenous life, whether it's education or health, government, all the economic, social, and cultural rights are wrapped into this one international law. I was asked to chair that meeting, which was a world conference. And that really got me going into the area of international law. Now it's been 22 years I've been going to the United Nations. So basically it's lawmaking. You're doing lawmaking at the international level through the United Nations system. When you practice law, you tend to interpret the law. When you're a parliamentarian, you're making the law. So professionally it gave me a better picture of law in a sense in our country. Both sides of the law, in a sense that the experience of being one of the members of parliament in Canada is just, I can't find the right words to do it except the honor of it. From the Indian Reservation to the House of Commons, to the Supreme Court of Canada, to the United Nations, without sports that was not possible. Actually, I started with the Bears on defense, and Coach Drake looked at me and he said, "How much do you weigh?" I said, 151. I said, "You better try forward." So I ended up playing forward. I think I just did whatever I had to do. If I had to turn the clock back, it would be to wish I had the weight I have today with the speed I had then. Because when you play college hockey at 151 pounds, was not, well, you're pretty light. So you had to make up a lot, I think, with speed. So I worked on that a lot.
Simple lighter, he sees the killer's face. Maybe it's someone standing.
My sister was going to go to law school, and I wanted to give her a gift, so I bought a Black's Law Dictionary. Dictionary in law is about 4 or 5 inches thick, and I wrote in her little memento on the front page, "You have to work harder than you can, because..." Well, you just have to. If you're an Indian person, you're expected to fail. If you go 100%, you're expected to go 110%. So I've just adopted that. Okay, if that's the way it's got to be, that's the way it will be. So I go 110%, or I keep working harder than I can. For me, I've certainly got an awful lot from my community. The support I've had over the years, whether it was in school or in sports or in business, opportunities to go and work all over the world. I have to pay back to the community for that opportunity, I think. This campus means an awful lot to me, right from the very first practice I attended. Academics was one thing, but the personal experience of friendship with other teammates, friendship with classmates, that to me was the spiritual uplifting part I mentioned earlier, because in a world where you're trying to put everybody else down, or put each other down, there's also an element that lifts you up. And whether it was student life, athletic life, the U of A provides all of that. All right.